For a new channel, this is viral for me. This video was created 2 days ago and already it has 233 views. Why is this exciting for me? It is because this 3D video people like to watch and see. You can compare with the other videos that we've created on the channel. The channel is like a month old and it's growing steadily. So if you're one wanting to grow a kiddies channel or a song kiddies channel, you have to incorporate 3D in your videos that you create. In today's video, we're going to be creating this video together using Canva. First thing that you're going to do is to create music, and you're going to be using Suno.ai. And if you've watched this video, you'll be able to create any type of music, including kids music. This music that I've created for Old MacDonald, we found it on Suno, and Suno gave us the lyrics as well. So the lyrics are going to be guiding how the video is going to look like. So the lyrics look like this. It is Old MacDonald had a farm on verse one, and there's an E-I-E-I-O. And we are going to look through all of the verses to see what kind of animal or what kind of character is going to pop up. So the first one, it's a farm, and the second one, it's a cow and a sheep and tomatoes and carrots and so on. So you're gonna make sure that you have all of these characters on your first scene, and then you're going to start adapting it as you go along. So the first step is music. The second step is to make sure how many characters you have, and you have them since from slide one. Therefore, you're going to open your Canva and you open the video canvas. So we're going to use the YouTube video, the 920 by 1080 canvas, and you open an Old MacDonald farm that you're going to be creating 3D. Once it's open, we're going to go to our elements and we're going to search for farm in 3D. So we're going to type farm 3D and we press enter. And you're going to be going through your graphics and you pick the farm that you want to use. Like this particular farm, it's called Country House 3D Icon by Haki. And we're going to add that to our canvas. So this would be our first slide. And we just create a nice gradient background. So I'm going to use the nice bluish gradient background. And I add my farm. And I'm going to size my farm and make it nice and big so that it fills the page. So that it can accommodate all of the animals that I'm going to be adding, because I'm adding 9 characters to the song. So I'm going to make it nice and big. Slide number one, it is our farm. Next step is to go to our song and add all of the characters as they follow each other. So the first one would be Old MacDonald had a farm. So I'm going to just now go to my Suno, download the music, which I've already done. And then you're going to go to your audio and go find the music that you've created. So when you click on it once, it starts adding it to your canvas, and then you can start listening to it. And it's nice. It ends almost at the end of the first 5 second slide, which is perfect. We want to start off by saying that Old MacDonald had a farm. And then we're going to go back to our 3D and we're going to look for a farmer. Now we're looking for a 3D farmer, because we're creating a 3D cartoon song, Nursery Rhyme. Nursery Rhymes are doing very well on YouTube. So while they're doing well and 3D is also doing well, we're going to definitely jump on them. And you scroll down and you pick the farmer that you want to use. Any farmer that you're happy with, you just add to the characters. So I'm going to pick this farmer and I'm going to make him small and add them to the farm. And that's my first character. Old MacDonald had a farm. Old MacDonald. I've just added Old MacDonald. Next character, it's a cow. So I'm going to go back to 3D cow. And you pick any cow you want. This is also cool. Make it small. You edit next to Old MacDonald. And after the cow, he had a sheep. 3D. And I go find the 3D sheep that I want to use. And you make it small. And you carry on like that until you have all of your characters. Great stuff. According to the song, these are the characters that play on this song. I'm happy with all of them. That does very well for my slide. And then I duplicate my first slide, so I have the exact same slide on slide 2. And in between, I'm going to be using the match and move. So you hover in the middle of the two slides and then you add your match and move, and it seamlessly goes very nice, and you will see what I mean now. On your second slide, because the song says he had a farm, so we want to make the farmer big on slide 2. And if you've used match and move, when you zoom the farmer out and you make him nice and big, and you right click on your layer, you send him to front of all of these animals. And you add a nice animation. So you're gonna click on animate, and you're going to scroll down to pulse, and you make him pulse like that, so that when the song plays, Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. It's giving him the props, or it's making him the character that the song is talking about. And the kids get excited because you're showing them the MacDonald dude that had a farm. And that's your slide 2. Once you're done, you're gonna go back to your first slide. Your first slide is very important in creating this. And you duplicate the first slide, and you take the first slide, you make it slide 3. So that when we are done making him the character that we're talking about, and we slide and we add a match and move, he will zoom back down. So let's play it and see how it looks like. See, because we've copied slide 1, it picks up what's happening on slide 1, it takes him back, so it zooms back. And then because now we're talking about the cow, we're going to click on the cow, make the cow big, because the cow is the character we're talking about, and we're going to position the cow in front of everybody. And we're gonna go to animate, and we make the cow pops like that, because we're talking about the cow. And when you play it, it looks like this. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a cow, E-I-E-I-O. So by the end of E-I-E-I-O on the cow, we're going to reduce the size. And then we're going to copy this slide, because the cow is still big and it says moo moo. So therefore, on the fourth slide, you're gonna select your cow, but you're gonna take away the pulse. So you're gonna scroll down and click on the pulse and remove the animation on slide 4, so that you can add the words that the song is singing about. So when you play enter, now, because she's singing about the cow being moo moo, we're going to create the moo moo of the cow and then add audio. So I go to my text and I scroll down and I go find a nice like sticker. I can use the sticker text effect thing. So I can click on that and add it to our character or our slide and then change the color and make it like a black and white as in the cow. So the effects, we're gonna go and change the color of the effects and make that black. And then we type moo moo. And you can always, on your effects, just make it curve a little bit so that it looks quite catching and cool. And then you add your first moo. You have to listen to the song and then you make the element pop out when the lady's singing moo moo. What do I mean by that? When you play it, so the first moo, I'm gonna select it, click on the ellipses, scroll down to go find the timing of the element, because I don't want it to go through the match and move transition. I want it to pop when it comes out. When you play it, it looks like this. You see, and it moves nicely without the transitioning being in the way. So I'm going to just make it nice and thicker and then duplicate that so that I have a second move and I move it to the side and then I listen to the song. I don't want the moo moo to be exactly the same, so I will reduce the second moo. And then, because I'm happy with this slide, I'm going to split the slide. And on my second page, I'm going to adjust my moo moos based to the song. So let's select it and then adjust it. And select it and adjust it. Duplicate my moo moo so that I have more moo moos. And then you go to your elements and you adjust them based on the song. Then you go back to your first slide, you duplicate, you grab slide 2, you add it to the last slide and you have what's going on exactly on slide 1. The last thing that you would do is to add the EIEIU. So I like the font kawaii. So we're going to press T for text and we're going to look for kawaii because it's nice and round and shapey. You can use whatever font you might like. I'm happy with that. And we're going to choose a nice blue color and we're going to write EIEIO. And you make it nice and big. And you just add it at the bottom. And you go to your animate and you type it. So you choose your typewriter so that it types the character. And then you can just work on the timing, make sure that it times it quite nicely, and just on enter and the character. And when we play it, it should look like this. By the time I get to the last bit, it's easy to duplicate the last page and then take off the EIEIO and then delete that. So you scroll down, you grab the chicken.
So I carried on like this for another 2 hours. It was lots of fun, but it is a lot of work, this 3D work that we absolutely love. If you want to watch the whole thing, I'm going to link it on this video. Plus, please don't forget to go and subscribe to my YouTube channel, The Kiddies One, Zoey's Jamboree. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on our next video.
Welcome to Zoey's Jamboree. Don't forget to like and subscribe.